Welcome all of you who are joining us. This Holy Triduum is the name for these 3 days of Holy Thursday, Good Friday, Easter. And it's just that to celebrate Jesus' suffering for us, his dying for us, and his resurrection to new life, it takes 3 days. And so each of these services are connected. So this whole holy period of 3 days, we're with Jesus and the disciples, with Mary and Mary Magdalene, in this experience of Jesus' dying and rising. And so we begin this holy 3 days. Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
As we gather before our Lord on these holy days, we ask for his forgiveness, healing, and help. Manitou kiti makinawinan. Manitou kiti makinawinan. Sezus kiti makinawinan. Sezus kiti makinawinan. Manitou kiti makinawinan. Manitou kiti makinawinan. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
People of good will, we pray.
Let us pray. Kitsamanato, who have called us to participate in this most holy sacred supper, in which your only begotten Son, Jesus, when about to hand himself over to death, entrusted to the church as sacrifice new for all eternity, the banquet of his love. Grant, we pray, that we may draw from so great a mystery the fullness of charity and of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. In our first reading today, we hear the story of the Passover. We're reminded that Jesus was Jewish. And so this is that celebration of that disease, of the killing of the firstborn, that if they had the blood of the Lamb on their doorposts, that the angel of death passed over them. We're praying for that grace today as well.
First readings are reading from the book of Exodus. The Lord said to Moses and Aaron in the land of Egypt, "This month shall mark for you the beginning of months. It shall be the first month of the year for you. Tell the whole congregation of Israel that on the 10th of this month, they are to take a lamb for each family, a lamb for each household. If a household is too small for a whole lamb, it shall join its closest neighbor in obtaining one. The lamb shall be divided in proportion to the number of people who will eat it. Your lamb shall be without blemish, a year old male. You may take it from the sheep or from the goats. You shall keep it until the 14th day of this month. Then the whole assembled congregation of Israel shall slaughter it at twilight. They shall take some of the blood and put it on the two doorposts and the lintel of the houses in which they eat it. They shall eat the lamb that same night. They shall eat it roasted over the fire with unleavened bread and bitter herbs. This is how you shall eat it: your loins girded, your sandals on your feet, and your staff in your hand, and you shall eat it hurriedly. It is the Passover of the Lord. For I will pass through the land of Egypt that night, and I will strike down every firstborn in the land of Egypt, both human beings and animals. On all the gods of Egypt I will execute judgments. I am the Lord. The blood shall be a sign for you on the houses where you live. When I see the blood, I will pass over you, and no plague shall destroy you when I strike the land of Egypt. This day shall be a day of remembrance for you. You shall celebrate it as a festival to the Lord. Throughout your generations, you shall observe it as a perpetual ordinance." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. The cup of blessing that we bless is a sharing in the blood of Christ.
The cup of blessing that we bless is a sharing in the blood of Christ.
What shall I return to the Lord for all his bounty to me? I will lift up the cup of salvation and call on the name of the Lord.
The cup of blessing that we bless is a sharing in the blood of Christ.
Precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his faithful ones. I am your servant, the son of your serving girl. You have loosed my bonds.
The cup of blessing that we bless is the sharing in the blood of Christ.
I will offer to you a thanksgiving sacrifice and call on the name of the Lord. I will pay my vows to the Lord in the presence of all his people.
The cup of blessing that we bless is the sharing in the blood of Christ.
Second reading, a reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, I received from the Lord what I also handed on to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night when he was betrayed, took a loaf of bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, "This is my body that is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, he took the cup also, after supper, saying, This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink the cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. The word of the Lord.
Thanks.
Lord be with you.
And with your
we have a reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Before the festival of the Passover, Jesus knew that his hour had come to depart from this world and to go to the Father. Having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. The devil had already put into the heart of Judas, son of Simon Iscariot, to betray him. And during supper, Jesus, knowing that the Father had given all things into his hands, and that he had come from God and was going to God, got up from the table, took off his outer robe, and tied a towel around himself. Then he poured water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and to wipe them with the towel that was tied around him. He came to Simon Peter, who said to him, "Lord, are you going to wash my feet?" And Jesus answered, "You do not know what I am doing, but later you will understand." Peter said to him, "You will never wash my feet." And Jesus answered, "Unless I wash you, you have no share with me." Simon Peter said to him, "Lord, my feet only, but also my hands and my head." And Jesus said to him, "One who has bathed does not need to wash, except for the feet, but it is entirely clean. And you know you are clean, though not all of you." For he knew who was to betray him, and for this reason he said, "Not all of you are clean." And after he had washed their feet, put on his robe, and returned to table, Jesus said to them, "Do you know what I have done to you? You call me teacher and Lord, and you are right, for that is what I am. So if I, your Lord and teacher, have washed your feet, you also ought to wash one another's feet, for I have set you an example that you should do also, as I have done to you." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Dear brothers and sisters, we would have been many in our cathedral and in our own parishes to celebrate the feast of the Last Supper of our Lord Jesus Christ. Unfortunately, the coronavirus prevents us from celebrating these great events in community. However, wherever you are, we offer this sacrifice of Mass for you and your families. Wherever you are, the Lord Jesus joins you to nourish you spiritually with his body. This celebration today is of great importance in our lives for three reasons. The first reason is it was at the Last Supper that Jesus instituted the sacrament of the Eucharist. Jesus is always present in our lives, but he is even more visible in the Eucharist, in his body and his blood. Unfortunately, there are many Christians who receive the body of Christ and are not convinced that Jesus is present in the piece of bread after the consecration. Others receive the body of Christ by routine, by habit, without being convinced that Jesus is really present. Those who believe in the presence of Jesus in the Eucharist receive abundant graces, gifts, spiritual and physical healing. A few days ago, some parishioners called me to say that they miss the body of Christ. I pray that in these difficult times that we spend in our homes, that he may help us to rediscover the value and importance of communion in our lives. The second reason is that it was during the Last Supper that Jesus instituted the priesthood. He ordered his apostles to repeat his gesture in memory of him. Today is an opportunity to pray for all priests, for vocations, for the ministers of the Eucharist who visit the sick, the elderly, and bring them communion. The third reason is that Christ left us a testament to service to one another. By washing the feet of his apostles, Jesus gave us an example of humility without which it is not possible to serve others. This time of quarantine is the right time to be attentive to others and to put yourself at the service of others. This service goes through very simple things. You can go shopping for people who have health risks. You can telephone single or elderly people. We can take the time to listen to those who need to speak. You can give enough time to your husband, to your wife, to your children and grandchildren. Jesus recommends that we remain in service dress, whether it is that of the housewife, that of the nurse, that of the doctor, or any profession. The important thing is to serve, to give the best of ourselves, and to make others happy. This is the command that Jesus Christ left us. Amen.
Now is the time in our Holy Thursday service where we reenact the washing of the feet, the Jesus washing the disciples. Because of physical distancing, we're not doing that this year. Who knows what Father Jim could get by washing my feet, my old feet. But we're going to take a moment for you to just reflect on what little acts of service are you called to do to show your love for God and his people. As Father Guillain mentioned, that it can be little things like washing the dishes, cleaning the bathrooms, shoveling April snow. So just to take a moment now to reflect on some little acts of service that we can do for God. We now have our prayers of the faithful, where we bring to God from our real hearts and struggles and pains our need for his help.
For the church, witness to true love and service in Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For world leaders, trusted by their people to promote justice and human dignity throughout true service, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For us, the body of Christ, called to pour out our lives for others, as Jesus did for us, we pray to the Lord.
We pray as well for all who have died from coronavirus 19 and for all who will, for all affected by it, and for all our health workers. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for any of your other intentions that you wish to pray for today.
We pray for all the priests, that they may be good shepherds for their folk, following the example of Jesus, full of patience, of kindness and love. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for those who are isolated. Think here particularly of our elders who are seemingly locked into homes and have no contact with family and loved ones. So for them, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of those struggling with illness, especially Tricia Adam, John Toussaint, and for all those struggling with other diseases and illness at this time, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Kitsamanato Niyotsina, hear the prayers we lift up to you. Help us to be strengthened by your Eucharist. Help us to serve you in acts of love and kindness. And we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine, work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Lord, wash away my iniquity, cleanse me from my sin. Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at our hands for the praise and glory of God's name, for our good and the good of all God's holy church. Grant us, Kitsamanato, we pray, that we may participate worthily in these mysteries. For whenever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord Holy Father, Almighty and eternal God. For Jesus is the true and eternal priest who instituted the pattern of an everlasting sacrifice and was the first to offer himself as the saving victim, commanding us to make this offering as his memorial. As we eat his flesh that was sacrificed for us, we are made strong. As we drink his blood, which he's poured out for us, we are washed clean. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, myself, your unworthy servant, and all those who hold to the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants, and all gathered here, whose faith and devotion are known to you. For us, we offer you this sacrifice of praise, and offer it for ourselves and for all who are dear to us, for the redemption of our souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying our homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. Celebrating the most sacred day on which our Lord Jesus Christ was handed over for our sake, and in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, Philip, and all the saints, we ask that through their merits and prayers, in all things we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family which we make to you as we observe the day on which the Lord Jesus Christ handed on the mysteries of his body and blood for his disciples to celebrate. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, for our salvation and for the salvation of all, that is today, he took bread in his holy hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, he took bread and to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and in his holy and venerable hands, And once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, Niotsina Seyadarie, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty, from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer we ask you, Kitsamanato, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing.
Remember also, Lord, your servants. Remember in a special way our relations who have died and who have gone before us with a sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace.
To us also, your servants, who, though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Agnes, Cecilia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. And now we pray together in the words that Jesus taught us for the gift of the Eucharist, the Mass, and for service. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen."
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. And
we now extend God's peace to you and invite you to share that peace with those of you in your home. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my room, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
We now invite you to make a spiritual communion in your home.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Kitsamanoto Niotsina, who have called us to participate in this most sacred supper, in which your only begotten Son, when about to hand himself over to death, entrusted to the Church a sacrifice new for all eternity, the banquet of his love, grant, we pray, that we may draw from such a great mystery the fullness of charity and of life. Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
So just some announcements is that Good Friday service will be at 3 p.m. You can follow us again tomorrow. Holy Saturday, the video will be available from 6 p.m. on for the Easter Vigil. And one of the things we're inviting people to do Holy Saturday night is to safely put a lit candle in your window so that all through our diocese, we have that symbol of Jesus's light coming into our darkness. And so a candle to be lit in your window Holy Saturday evening. Easter, all our churches that have bells will ring their bells at noon. And in your own home, you may wish to ring a bell if you wish at noontime to celebrate our Easter Sunday. We will now have the stripping of the altar, and there'll be a time for adoration of the Blessed Sacrament of Jesus's body. And it's just that image of us joining Jesus in the Garden of Gethsemane this evening, Holy Thursday night, as Jesus is praying, "Let this cup pass from me, but not my will, your will be done."